Hi, I'm Saddam Karnik and these are my vlogs. I don't think the snappy edits are working, and the reason for that is because this isn't about quick edits and showing you a montage of what the vlog is about or my lifestyle. This is about me, what I feel, my questions, why I started this vlog off, and so on and so forth. So, to answer the three questions which I started this vlog off from, which was primarily, why am I doing this? What's my purpose and what am I learning from this? If you saw my first episode, I asked myself these questions and I didn't have an answer for them. It was all like, I don't know, let's see, and then that was the attitude. Well, I'm about six vlogs down now, and I have a fair amount of idea as to what those answers are. And I think down the line, I'll have more answers to the same question, which will be good because I can keep going back and looking at those answers again and seeing how I've evolved. And that's, again, the entire point of doing this vlog. So, the first question I asked myself, why am I doing this? As an actor, I get a lot of time in between work and basically doing nothing or trying to find that work, and that doesn't really take up all of my time. That all of my time kind of frustrates me, and me as a person, I'm quite restless. So I felt this is a very good way to sort of constructively use my time. The second question, what's my purpose of doing this? I watched Casey Neistat. He's actually my inspiration for vlogging. Great guy, check him out if you haven't. He's in fact the inspiration for a lot of vloggers who are starting off, and so for me also. His basic thing was you do more. In whatever little you have, you do more. And that sort of hit a nerve in me. Somewhere it kind of connected, and you just have one life. If you live it right, I'm going to say that again. You just have one life, and if you live it right, once is enough. But in that one lifetime, it's up to you if you just want to sit around and wait for things to happen or make the best of what there is and make the best happen for you of that. And that's the sort of logic I'm trying to do with this project. I don't know what this is going to lead to. Even if this is the end of the episode, that's fine, because I set out to do 6 vlogs and I did that and I had a great time doing it. It was a great learning experience. And I think I'm going to continue doing it until I feel right. I am my own boss, I am my own contract over here, and this is me. What am I going to learn from this? Off the bat, editing. Off the bat, camera work. As an actor, I was aware of those forms, those art forms, but I was never into it. And the entire point of this is to kind of get myself out of my own comfort zone and learn a new skill, which I have. In its most basic senses, I've learned editing. I initially started off with trying to get someone on board to edit the vlogs for me, because I didn't know how to go about it. But for whatever reasons, he backed out and I was left to myself. And the entire point I realized of this vlog was to do more. So I said, hey, why don't I just kind of do the edits myself. So everything you see now has been edited by me, shot by my wife and I at different times, depending on whoever's got the camera. And it was all learned self-taught. Another reason for me to do this is that I've always believed that I'm creative. I've always believed that I can think up of original ideas, just do something. And the only creative work so far I've been able to do is my acting. And that too has its own limitation, because when you see me on screen, there's a process, there's a full team which goes behind all of that. And although you're seeing me, there's a lot of everyone else's work attached behind to it, which is great, but that's not my creativity. It's fantastic. Please don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that's not creative. That's extremely creative and satisfying as well. But maybe I'm trying to look for something more over here, because the entire point is to do more. So this, I felt, is an extremely creative platform, which is also very excusable a medium, because I can shooting this at home on my iPhone without any sound, nothing. And I think that just does the job to put the message across, because you ask any YouTuber, successful YouTuber, they'll say the gear doesn't matter, it's the content. And that's what I'm trying to create, the content, and try to be creative with that. It's been a bit of a lifestyle change for me as well. My friends, my family has to do a bit of an adjustment, because there's going to be another person in our lives, so to speak. But then again, I just want to say they've been extremely supportive and encouraging of this. And all my friends, if I start to annoy you, I don't care. You are my friends for a reason, and I know you'll stick through me for this as well. So I love you guys, and I know you love me, and I know you support me on this. Speaking of support, my biggest support is someone I want to thank right now, my wife, Megha. I love you. You've been a supportive pillar beyond anything I've been to you so far, and I just want to take this opportunity to thank you. I'm using your cameras, I'm using your laptop, I've been hogging on it, taking you off it completely. I'm going to get my own stuff very soon, but until then, I just want to say thank you. You've really supported me through this, and I love you for this. Moving on, I have upped my equipment, and I'm so excited about that because I have upgraded to my new camera. It's the Canon EOS M6. Now, before I unwrap this, I just want to thank Tube Noon. He's the guy who I went to. I was in a bit of a dilemma which camera to get as my first vlogging camera, and of course the net is cluttered with ideas and suggestions, and I was sort of stuck between the two, but I contacted him. I just randomly texted him in his comment sections, and he was very quick in with the reply, and he recommended this camera to me. I looked into it and I thought this was perfect. So Tube Noob, thank you so much. Guys, please just kind of subscribe to him if you want to know about technical stuff, cameras, everything. He does fantastic jugaad, which is again another reason I like his resourcefulness. So, thank you, buddy. It's time to open my gifts. That brings us to the end of this vlog. Thank you for sticking with me. I've had a lot of fun. I'm going to really now focus on my gifts, see how they all kind of come back together, and show you more reviews. Linking inside my Instagram, my Twitter, follow it. There's more of me over there, or don't follow, but just do watch this. Write me comments. I will try to reply to you as much as I can. I have a Facebook page as well. Anju Jahanji, she handles that. So kind of link yourselves through there. We'll just streamline a better way that I can answer questions to you. I will not be able to answer as often as I would like to because I have another life which I have to balance as well, and I cannot devote completely all my time to this. But this has been fun. This has been wonderful. And thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe. Please like. Please share. I think that's important when you vlog, so understand that. Meanwhile, haters, be kind. Lovers, be mine. I will see you all soon.